Very good evening, viewers. I begin on a regretful note. I regretfully inform you today of a plot to plunge India into political chaos in the ultimate act of treachery, so to speak. Two individuals have been trying to eliminate our Prime Minister, Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Times Now has accessed details of a charge sheet filed by the Surat anti-terror squad that reveals that two radical Islamist terrorists came very close to executing a plot to assassinate India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Here are the hard facts. Up front, as always, Gujarat ATS files chilling charge sheet. This charge sheet details and exposes a terror plot. Investigators intercept social media messages that have been transmitted and found on the equipment, telephonic devices, and other instrumentalities that have been recovered from these two individuals. The suspects planned to procure weapons, and when they were doing so, they were tracked, apprehended, and subsequently, after pen drives from them were recovered, this plot came to the forefront. Now, the two Islamist radicals who conspired to assassinate Prime Minister Narendra Modi are Ubaid Mirza. He's a practicing lawyer, resided in Surat, part of the social media group Ansar-ul-Tawheed. There's another conspirator, Qasim Stimbarwala. He's a hospital lab technician, resided in Surat, and wished to join a radical group in Jamaica. Now, a chilling and damning confession has been extracted. The messages that confirm the plot. The medium used was a social media app, the group's name Ansar-ul-Tawheed. The center was Ubaid Mirza. This happened on September 10, 2016 at 11:24 p.m. And what was the content? The content was, if a pistol is to be bought, I will try to find a contact with him. Again, medium social media app, group name Ansar-ul-Tawheed, sender Qasim Stimbalwala. September 10th, this message was sent 2016 at 11:28 p.m. The content of this message is very, 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 very alarming. And let me quote directly. Yeah, says this individual to the other suspect, let's take Modi out with a sniper rifle. This is the conversation. This is the conversation that transpired. It's very serious, very diabolical. It's all now mentioned in a charge sheet which has been filed in a court. There is enough, according to our sources in the ATS, enough information, enough proof to prosecute these two individuals. The group name Ansar-ul-Tawheed, which is really a extraction of a very diabolical terror organization that is banned in India. And that terror organization is called the Indian Mujahideen. Viewers might recall that the Indian Mujahideen was active in the late 2000s when it carried out several terror attacks across the length and breadth of India, posting some very threatening messages promising to break up our nation. Now, the questions that arise are obviously serious, but before I get to them, I want to go across to Nikunj Garg, our internal security editor, who knows a little bit more about this diabolical attempt and plot to kill the Prime Minister. What can you tell us, Nikunj?
Well, Rahul, in terms of the incriminating evidence, there is a 164 CRPC statement, which is clearly recorded in front of the magistrate. These individuals were the member of the same messaging group, that social media app from which these messages have been recovered, who have now, some of them have now turned police approvers, and they have volunteered to record a statement in front of a magistrate, understanding the full gravity as cautioned by the duty magistrate who recorded that statement. The fact of the matter is also this, Rahul, that in Ansarul Tawheed is a splinter group, as you said, of the remnant elements of the Indian Mujahideen, and Indian Mujahideen in the past has displayed an ability which probably no other terror group, which consisted of primarily Indian youth, primarily Indian Muslim youths, has displayed, and that ability is to strike across the country, even in cities like Jaipur, which have never seen any kind of terror strike before. Indian Mujahideen struck that city, and an uncanny ability of using technology to the best of their advantage, befooling best of the investigators and best of investigating agencies in this country, like we have seen the use of open Wi-Fi's by Manzoor Asghar Peerboy in case of Mumbai terror strikes when Indian Mujahideen struck that city. So clearly that group has the determination, that group has the technological wherewithal. In the past, it also had the kind of necessary muscle to carry out those terror strikes, and this Ansarul Tawheed becomes a little more dangerous because these boys have exposed, some of them, these boys have moved from Pakistan to Afghanistan, where they have been exposed to some of the most deadly terror organizations. And that the sniper rifle, Rahul, that they are talking is very interesting, because sniper rifle is something that you will only find in our immediate neighborhood in places like Afghanistan. It's not a weapon very easily available inside India or even just outside India. So very clearly they have the wherewithal, they have worked out their plans, and two of them actually wanted to escape, to make good their plan, and that's when the ATS of Gujarat, which has done some exemplary anti-terror work, and I must here also inform our viewers that it was the initial tip-off for the complete bust of Indian Mujahideen actually came from Gujarat ATS. It was only on the tip-off and some telephone numbers recovered by the Gujarat ATS that the Central Intelligence Bureau started working on it, and Indian Mujahideen was finally exposed, and before that Butla House encounter took place. So clearly it's a diabolical group with the necessary wherewithal to convert its thought into an actionable plan.
Well, stay on with me, because obviously the question then needs to arise and will arise and needs to be asked, rather. And this question is a one that the opposition must ponder. Has the time come now for the opposition to end its demonization of Prime Minister Modi with its hateful rhetoric? Here are some instances in the past when netas resorted to hateful statements against Prime Minister Modi, which create a sense of alienation, disenfranchisement amongst a section of our population, or at least have the potential to arouse such feelings. Listen to some of these sound bites. They were made in the heat and dust of political campaigning, as well as, of course, by individuals who thought that by portraying our Prime Minister in a particular light, they could actually gain politically. The damage will not be restricted to a political party. It will be restricted. It will in fact spread across the nation in an eventuality such as this. So politicians, watch out. There are serious implications to the irresponsible statements you make. Let's first play out these statements. I'll jog your memories, viewers. Think about this.
गुजरात की सरकार चलाने वाले झूठे बेईमानी डर और मौत के सौदागर हैं।
वो गुजरात समझ रहा 4% मुसलमान है गुजरात में, यहाँ 42% मुसलमान है, यहाँ गुजरात की गोटी काट देंगे छुट्टी।
मौत का सौदागर, वी विल कट हिम टू पीसेस, सम वेरी रिस्पॉन्सिबल स्टेटमेंट्स मेड बाय द ऑपोजिशन. They continue in different contexts even now. We have heard Khoon Ki Kheti. We have heard several other references odious references to the Prime Minister, subtle dog whistle politics to evoke a certain sentiment amongst a certain section of our polity. And in the wake of the assassination plot against the Prime Minister, should the deliberate demonization of the Prime Minister in political discourse stop immediately?